This is the arm and hand of an eye, and these are its five creepy, spindly little fingers. And this right here, this is the sixth finger of the eye, the eye's pseudo-thumb. When I was 14, I started working at the American Museum of Natural History with a famous lemurologist, and he gave me this field guide to the lemurs of Madagascar that I took with me on all of my early trips to Madagascar, the only place that lemurs are found. As a professional anatomist now, I recognize that lemurs are among the most amazing animals in the world, and the most amazing among the lemurs is the eye. Eyes are unique for a bunch of reasons. They have really bizarre anatomy. The most striking piece of anatomy is this long middle finger, and it's very skinny, and it actually has a ball and socket joint in the middle so that the eye's finger doesn't just close like ours does, like a hinge joint, but it can swivel around. And what it does is it takes this finger and it taps along wood, and it uses a form of echolocation to hear voids in that wood, and then it sticks this skinny little finger in there to fish out grubs. One of the things that we study in our lab is forearm musculature, and we were dissecting this exact specimen, and we traced one of the tendons all the way into the hand from the forearm, and that tendon split. One part went where it was supposed to be going. The other part went to this weird little appendage here, this accessory digit. And that was the first time that anybody had ever realized that eyes have this secret sixth finger.
The morphological features of the eye pseudothumbs are very small and subtle. So we took our eye specimen and collected MRI data from it so that we could visualize these muscles and tendons in digital space. So looking at these scans, we were able to figure out that the eye pseudothumb consists of both a bony portion and a cartilaginous extension. In addition to these structures, we also identified three distinct muscles attaching to the pseudothumb that allows the eye to manipulate this digit in three different directions. And collectively, these three muscles were capable of exerting almost a kilogram of force during contraction.
All of the eye's fingers became so specialized for this tap foraging behavior that they really lost their functionality for gripping, similar to how the panda also lost its functionality for gripping. The most famous example of the pseudo-thumb is that of the giant panda. Panda's thumbs are integrated with the rest of their fingers. And this is really useful when you're walking around to not have a thumb to step on. But while this is useful for walking, it's not very useful for grabbing stuff. And since pandas need to grab bamboo, they had to have some kind of structure to help them do that. And rather than having that thumb be opposable again, what they developed was the pseudo-thumb sticking out of the wrist. And the pseudo-thumb of the panda has the exact same bone and muscles that we find in the pseudo-thumb of the eye. As an evolutionary biologist, it's really exciting to be able to document this amazing example of convergent evolution. And as somebody who's been passionate about lemurs for a really long time, it's super exciting to be able to find a piece of anatomy in a lemur, and especially the weirdest lemur of all. It's really a dream come true.